Hello, my name is Hearts, welcome back to the channel, and we will be continuing our hearty let's play of Final Fantasy XV. In the last video, surprise surprise, the peace treaty slash ceasefire meeting between Niflheim and the Kingdom of Lucis did not go so well, ending up in Niflheim attacking the Crown City. In the attack, the Crown City of Lucis Insomnia lost its crystal and its ring of Lucy, which is basically the two items, without getting too complicated, the two items that give the kingdom its magic. Unfortunately, Noctis had to learn this right before he's about to get on a boat to meet Lunafreya and get married, and so him and the crew decide to go back to the city in order to see if it's true. And lo and behold, they see once they get to the border of the Crown City, they find that it's overrun with Novgardian soldiers, Magitek soldiers, and they get a call from Kor, who is the captain of the King's Guard, who's, I think his title entails what the name implies, and tells them to, if they want to learn the truth, they have to come find him. For those of you who saw the last episode, I wonder if I should call it episodes, but for those of you who saw the last video and are wondering why I'm in this area of the map, it's because while off screen I've discovered this dungeon that I tried out, and while the normal enemies are pretty easy to defeat, they're all like level 7, the boss at the end is level 52, so I got my ass handed to me, so I'll come back to this one later. Also off screen, we got a call from Dino asking us to come see him, so we'll go ahead and do that, and then we'll go on with the rest. We'll head over to see Kor. Also, in the last video, we got some information that I thought was interesting, that Cid was really close friends with King Regis, Noctis' father. Like, he was part of his crew back then, his group before, just like Noctis' group before, so, and I hope to learn more about that, because yeah, that was surprising to me. That was very interesting. Let's see. Let's go to here. Yes. Or fast travel, whichever. Doesn't matter. Also, I forgot to comment on it while we were watching the cutscenes and stuff, but I gotta hand it to Noxus's voice actor, Ray Chase, I think he did a great job there of conveying his frustration and anger at everything that's happening, like losing his home. And while I think he emoted very well, I feel like the rest of the group was pretty subdued, and upon thinking about it a little more, I realized an exception for Gladio, Ignis's and Prompto's life revolve very heavily around Noctis. They really are essentially there to be his support, so they don't have as many connections back in the Crown City. Although it's their home, their bigger concern is making sure that Noctis stays safe now that Niflheim has taken control, and I think that's the more pressing concern. Alright, so let's see what Dino wants.
There he is, the prince himself. You look good.
You know.
Hey, sorry about the whole boat thing. I pulled some strings, but ain't nothing anyone could do after that fiasco at the Citadel.
Forget it.
Done and done. Man, I tell you, this reporter gig alone ain't enough to pay the bills. So I've been working real hard on the side.
Wow.
Yep. So, you busy?
Why?
Because I need your help. You fetch me some more, I trade you one of my pieces. Just like last time. Bada bing, bada boom.
Okay, alright. You've lost your home, I'm sorry for you. Your dad's dead. Here, what? Could you go and find this thing for me? I mean, it's
Seems
a game.
Our well-being is less important than his livelihood.
It really, yeah.
And we fell for it.
Guy's got no dignity, but he's full of deceit.
I don't mind helping him, so long as it doesn't involve any danger.
If it's we're in a video game, it's gonna involve danger. I was totally fooled. I thought that he really did have something to tell us or whatever, and yeah, no, it turns out he's just sending us out on another fetch quest. Okay, so let me go ahead and make that the main thing. Scenic thriller. Okay, cool. So yeah, I'll do this really quickly, and then I'll go ahead and head over to go meet Core. Ugh, messed that up again. Oh, some changes since the since those cutscenes have happened while I was exploring around at night. Now ships appear that drop down Magitek soldiers, like in the numbers and like in the tens of numbers, I think. And also demons start appearing at night now, stronger ones, like level 30. And I think if I gave it the time, like, you could beat them, even though I'm like, well, level 12 now. I could beat them if I like really put in the effort, but in the end, this is, well, I think there's a certain level of skill you can have in this game. Where is it? Oh wait, map point. Let's go take me here. No. That is destination. Yes. Yeah, well, I think you can have a certain level of skill in this game and like really circumvent levels, basically. It is still a numbers game, so you still have to have, I mean, because then at that point, it's just like you're playing against not getting hit one hit and you're downed and you have to like either heal yourself or get back up. So, yeah. But it's a nice challenge. I think this game, while it is a numbers game, you can have a certain level of skill that can allow you to bypass that to a certain degree. Although, like in that dungeon, the level with the level 52 boss at the end, that's a huge gap. Like one strike was sending me into the death throw. If I didn't have like a Phoenix down, which I don't have many of right now, that was it. And the damage I was doing to him was very little. But if I had, I bet there's people out there who could do it. They could do that no hit crit damage run or whatever. Not that good. I have a lot of faith in my gaming ability for this game, but not that much. Right. Oh, I just realized to comment on this, but yeah, I changed the color of the car because, I mean, yeah, it, like in that last video with all the streaks and everything, it totally took away a bit of the seriousness of that scene, with the rain and everything, and it's like all dour and stuff. Yeah, so I changed it back to a normal color-ish that, yeah, colors I think I would get for my car. I think I would get like this kind of bluish exterior with this orange brownish interior. I like that. Huh, I haven't been to this side of... Yeah, I haven't been to this side of the of this map before. This actually looks kind of different. I haven't been around here. Where are we exactly? Where are we on the map? Oh, that's weird. Oh, I guess maybe I never, like, actually looked at the drive from Golden Key to here. Because, yeah, it's pretty much the same. Oh, wait. Oh no, I'm on the wrong side quest. I just realized that. Okay, well, okay, might as well deliver it while we're here. This is a side quest I picked up right before ending the video on the last thing, where he told us to get some ingredients to give this guy. So, okay, so I'll do that, and then I'll do the other one for Dino. I bet it was much closer.
See that you buy no more than we need.
Sheesh, mm-hmm. You my mother or something?
Mum's the word.
Ignis has always been like Noctis's mom. He's caretaker. Like in Ignis's episode for the Brotherhood series, when Noctis moves out of the castle or whatever, whichever you would call it, the building where Regis, like royalty, stays and lived in an apartment, like Ignis was the one cleaning up his room and making him food and
what can I do you for?
Making sure he reads some reports, military reports, and all that kind of stuff.
Right.
Hold on. Give me a second. Take delivery. No turning back. I needed a... Yeah, I have the pepper. All I have to do is give it to him.
How's it going, boys?
There we go.
I can tell you all about the area.
No, I don't want more markers. I mean, I'll look at them later, but... Not when I don't know what's going on. Hold on. That's so strange.
If y'all liked it, come on back.
Oh, there we go. I was like, that's weird. That was a weird way to do it.
Too easily. I thought Sid told you to give us work.
Yeah, well, I guess I went a little soft on you. I'll be sure to give you more of a challenge next time. How's about that? Anywho,
yeah, maybe a fetch quest actually involves fighting something.
Here's a little care package. Should make for good eating.
Appreciate the ingredients, though. I love doing the cooking stuff, so. Alright, in 300 experience, that's always nice. Jihi ham, linden potato, sheep milk, and fungar. All ingredients. Oh.
He said it makes good eating.
Alright, I'll cook it up at our next camp.
That you will. Oh my god, he has another quest. Alright, let me just pick it up really quickly. Let me see what he wants now.
Oh, hey boys. You got time to lend a fella a helping hand?
Long's it's not a simple shopping trip this time.
Nope, this one's gonna take some effort. I'm sending y'all straight to the source this time. In other words, it's hunting time. The stuff I want y'all to collect, I'm fixing to use in a new dish. Hope you can help me out.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, exactly. Fetch quest with something to actually fight. So, oh, dagger quill. I'm actually kind of interested in that. I haven't fought that monster yet. I'm interested to see what it does. Let's see. Where is it? Legacy, that's Noctis's thing. Hunters and gatherers. And he gives us a shit ton of ingredients too. Where is it exactly? Right there. And his quest is right there. I do want to get to core stuff, but I want to do this stuff too. Maybe I'll just port there. Do jump cuts there to make it faster. Yeah, I'll just do jump cuts. Okay, so I'll do these side quests and get to core. See you guys in a bit.
So he's creating a new dish.
That's what he says, anyway. Cool. Wonder what he's cooking up.
Let's do this hunt and find out.
They will have sealed off the city by now.
What do you think it's like inside? I don't know. Your guess is as good as mine.
We'll see for ourselves in time.
Indeed. Merely a question of when.
Yeah. I can't believe the crystal's gone.
The bastards took it all.
And we'll take it back.
This is far from over.
Here's to that. Oh, wait a minute. Is this taking me back to the thing I showed in video like 2? Cause if it is, I can't kill that thing. Oh wait, it is. It totally is, isn't it? But I thought that was called something different.
These are the targets, right?
Oh, okay, there we go. Oh, okay. They moved it. Okay. Ooh, we're gonna actually get in some air combat, I think.
Any plan of attack?
Oh, I messed it up. Ooh, this gives me a chance to actually test out a combat thing. Let me see if I can pull it off. Ah, messed it up. See, back when the demo was released, there was this really good video. Like, you fight, not Behemoth, but basically he fights the thing. There's a video of a guy who fights it entirely in air, and he just teleports to these points to recover magic and stuff, but he never touches the ground. And if I can pull that off, that would be awesome. That would be really, really cool, actually. Oh god, I messed it up. Oh, it's hard, because like, to... Oh, okay, did it. Yeah, okay, I didn't touch the ground. Awesome.
Before it spoils.
Alright. So, sorta, kinda. That was a very shaky version of it, but at least that I got a kill, and I was able to warp. So yeah, it does. I was wondering as long as you hold down the triangle button to warp, will it just do it for you, even though you don't have a point warp in sight? And I think it does, so that's good for me. All right, so now I will jump cut to Dino's mission and clear the stuff up. See you guys in a bit.
A Magitek engine, it's close.
I know I said that I was gonna go to and jump cut to Dino's mission next, but I decided since it's right here in the way, might as well just hand this off really quickly. let's just, yeah, let's see. Let's just do this. He'll probably give, he'll probably have a new one ready immediately after I hand give this to him.
Oh, how was the hunt, boys?
Good. What are you gonna make with this stuff?
Something I know you'll like.
You mean?
Yep. So y'all make sure to drop by and order some.
Oh, that's cool. So it becomes like a permanent addition to the menu. That's dope. I wonder if I eat it, if it will give me, ooh, more experience. Awesome. Jingay wheat, dual hand steak, leading pepper. I think I'm pronouncing all this correctly. All right, I want to test.
What can I do you for?
I want to try that new meal and see if it'll give me something different. Ooh, that's cool. Yeah, that looks good. Let's add it. I just ran out of my status effects anyway, too, so might as well just get some new ones really quickly. All right, sweet. Ignis, did you learn anything? Yes, I thought so. All right, sweet. Okay.
I had your fill. Good.
But I have a bunch of AP points that I need to spend in a bit. Oh, yep. Like, look, he already has another one. I'll accept this one, but I won't do it, and I'll save it for off screen. I'll probably off screen.
Oh, there you are. So, you want to do me a favor?
Sure. What is it this time?
Another hunt. My cupboard's darn near empty.
Okay, we're up.
Knew I could count on y'all. Good hunting.
Yeah. This one I'll just do off screen. If this is like a line of quest, then I'll just complete it off screen. I'll probably, if not, if it seems like it's an unlimited one, I'll just leave it alone.
Could do his own hunting.
Take his chef's knife and doink.
He's no doubt aware of the proper points of separation. Would be quite the carver.
Not creepy at all.
I love the interactions between the group. They're great. This is some really good voice acting. Like Ray Chase's Noctis's actor, he's been in more anime than video games, it looks like, when I was looking at his discography. I think that's how I pronounce it. His career history. He did a lot of more anime stuff, but now since this game, he has appeared in more video games. I think the one who has more video, who has like the most video game experience actually in this group of voice actors, is the one who does the voice acting for Prompto, because he was actually the main character in one of the Tales game. He was Soray's voice actor in one of the Tales games. I can't remember which one, but it's the one that came out before Berseria. What am I doing here? I'm not gonna do the AP points yet. I was gonna go and set Dino's mission as the thing. Right, and now I will teleport to that. So see you guys there. Okay, so we're here. Dino's mission, our quest is that far away. So we'll head over there. I wonder what it is we're gonna fight. But oh, I see a dual horn.
This has gotta be the place.
All that's left is to find the stone.
Tain amethyst stone. Ooh, amethyst, pearl, garnet.
Knocked.
Is there a Steven around? What? Overhead? Oh, okay. Niflheim soldiers. Gotcha. Alright, let's kill these guys really quickly. I actually got attacked by these things like twice while off screen, while I was in between doing the hunt and heading back to Hammerhead. So I like these random encounters. I like fighting these things. And they're just a high level enough that they're dangerous to me still. Ooh, gotta take out the snipers first. Or at least try to take out the snipers first, having a bit of a time targeting. Gotta be careful next to waste out my magic too, I don't go around. There we go. Ooh. Actually getting into a bit of trouble here. Oh shit, my team is taking a lot of damage. Okay, let's use Mega Potion.
Stay down!
Yeah, they're just strong enough that they're dangerous. So let me use some tech moves, actually. The guns, I'm having a hard time how to handle them, because it's like I have to dodge them to cost a bit of magic. Let's do enhancement. I'm just taking a lot of damage. I love enhancement. But I should probably, for more area damage, I should throw back Ignis's target move thingy. Oh! Oh, that is sick. Oh, that look, that's my first time seeing that one. Dope. Oh, Prompto's down. Let's heal him up. Do I have any hype? Yes, do I do. Prompto.
Got it.
There we go. Sweet.
That was a close one.
Yeah.
So close for comfort.
I'm comfortable just being alive.
All right. So an amethyst stone. I think I saw a stone ore right over here. Oh, and it's getting dark, so I need to get back to the car before we get attacked by any.
Time to give him the goods.
There we go. Sweet. So that's taken care of. All right. So now I'll go ahead and head back to Dino, do that, and then we're on our way to Korra and continuing the story. See you guys in a sec. Alright, so we are back here at Golden Key. Let's go ahead and hand Dino his amethyst. Oh man. I actually had a cool thought. If he actually makes us go look for a pearl and a garnet, I actually appreciate it. I don't know if Tabata is a big fan of Steven Universe, but actually be a very cool nod to that. Back.
You guys hold up all right out there?
More or less.
Excellent. Come on, you ought to be proud of yourself, Your Highness. The work you did today could save lives.
How's that?
Well, you see, most folks know better than to go out at night. But okay. Some people don't have a choice, am I right?
True.
They may not have a choice, but my pieces can give them a chance. So hey, how's about you give it a try and see for yourself? I'm a man of my word, so here you go. I look forward to doing business with you again sometime, gentlemen.
Alright. Dope. Okay, so it's for a good cause, I guess. I mean, it's kind of worth it. Amethyst bracelet. Ooh, I almost. Ah, please. Oh man, give me a pearl.
Really
give me a search for.
Out of scope, Your Highness. You might just have a future in journalism.
What are you talking about?
At least that makes one of us.
Ooh, burn.
So look, I need a hand. Thing is, it's too dangerous for your average Joe. That's where you come in. I'll make it worth your while.
Stone-studded stunner. Let's see. Does it make me go look for a garnet? Let me check really quickly. No, it doesn't. Okay. All right. That's too bad. But that's another one I will take care of off screen. Right. For right now, we're going to make our way to Korra and continue on this story. Actually, let me go see what that amethyst bracelet does. Let me see if it's any good. Actually, what does it do? Oh, I got all of these from like off screen. Let me see what they do really quickly. Ancient Fencer, Vitality, Strength, Vitality, Ballistic. Oh, Ballistic Damage. Ooh, I might give that to Prompto. Study with Amethyst, increases strength incrementally. I'll give myself, I'll stick with the Titan Bangle. I'm gonna give Prompto the ballistic, the bulletproof vats, because I mean he is the gunner, so I think that's useful. He does seem to take the most damage out of everybody. He has the lowest health too. And I'll give Gladio the amethyst bracelet. Yeah, I think that would be good for him since he's the brute. He is the brawn of the group. All right, cool. So, right.
Here we go again.
Given our run-ins with him thus far, I doubt this excursion will go unrewarded.
Yeah, but I'm still running his errands.
This is the guy who agreed to run them.
Fetch quests, I mean, can't escape them, really. Okay, so now, yes, we will head to Korra. See you guys there. All right. We are getting close to our destination. And this was a pretty long drive, the longest drive I had to do so far in this game. And I got a chance to appreciate the soundtrack. Went through a bit of 13-7, and even like they had some Nier Automata songs in here, which I guess they had to have added an update or something. But I forgot. I mean, as much as I kind of, I mean, I don't. I do like 13. I forgot how much I enjoyed the soundtrack. The soundtrack of 13 was all right. There was actually some tracks on there that I actually did enjoy.
This must be the outpost Sid mentioned.
Okay.
It looks like a hub for hunters.
Maybe they know something.
Oh, maybe I'll actually get to buy some new weapons here too. And there's the quest that I need, side quest I need to pick up.
Hey,
let's check out the shop real quick.
This time.
Let's see what they got. Broadsword. Nope, same stuff. Okay. Nothing new. Okay, and they don't have any bulletproof ballistic armor anymore either, so. Because if I had one more, I would give it to Ignis, because he's also another one. He dies pretty quickly under fire. It's hard to dodge those.
Across the land, Scylla Blossoms from Tenebrae can be seen displayed in memoriam. With no remains to mourn, throngs have gathered in Alticia to pay their respects. Many offering prayers at a vigil held before the wedding dress Lady Luna Freya was to wear. While some hold out hope the Oracle still lives, a grim silence continues to linger.
Yeah, after the incident at the Crown City, they are reporting that Noctis and Luna Freya are dead, which isn't true. And I think they know that both of us are still alive, because, I mean, across this area, Magitek soldiers are able to find Noctis, and Luna Freya was able to escape with the help of some of the characters in Kingsglaive. And we also know another bit of important information to know is that she has the Ring of Lusai or the Ring of Kings, whichever one, which is, like I said, the two items necessary to give that kingdom, Noctis's kingdom, their magical abilities. So it will be important to reunite with her very soon.
Howdy. Just heard word of another lost tag. Don't know where you boys are headed, but would y'all mind picking it up if it's on your way?
Yeah, if it's on the way, sure. Look for the dog tag. Dust to dust. All right, so let's go ahead. Oh, actually, where is that? So let me see where I know to look for it. Okay, it's like right there. I'll put like a marker on it. Wait, no, it's right here. Can I put a marker? Okay, so I'm gonna put back on legacy and I'll put a marker over here. I can't, so I have to go to the map itself. It's right around here somewhere. Okay, cool. So I have that just as a reminder. Okay, so let's go ahead and talk to this person who might have information. Available C and HQ representative for TTLs. Okay. Sure. Talk to this person, I believe.
Your Highness, I'm glad you're safe.
Monica, wow. Where are all the others?
Most of the Crown's Guard didn't make it. It was all we could do to escort Lady Iris out of the city. Mm-hmm. Dustin is with her as we speak.
Oh, okay. Yeah, okay, that's good. That deletes. Because Noctis, I think Noctis as a character, at least, they didn't know for sure if Luna was alive. I mean, we know she was, but he didn't know, so now he does, at least. So
cool. Seeing her the rest of the way to Lestalem.
I owe you guys big time.
Head for the royal tomb. The marshal awaits.
Yes, another magic flask. I was hoping for that because, yeah, I need, in order to make more spells, like, I can collect all the elements I want, like the ingredients, but in order to actually have another spell, I need the flask to make it in. So I'm going to create one really quickly. I have a blizzard-based one, so let me do that really quickly. I feel like it's good to have one of each element. No, more blizzard. And there we go. And now let's add a thingy. Stop. Fossil. Yeah, I think stop and blizzard as a combination is a perfect fit. So let's add that. Awesome. Perfect. All right. So let's go ahead and head to the royal tomb and see what Koro has to tell us or give us. Maybe something to even the battlefield. Who knows? Something fun, hopefully, in the end, anyway. This is an interesting area.
I can't keep up with this guy.
First the Crown City, then Hammerhead, then the Royal Tomb?
His nickname should have been Kor the Restless.
Somehow not as catchy as Kor the Immortal.
Making it out of insomnia only adds to his legend.
Well, fortune favors the bold.
Well, huh?
The wise make their own luck.
You think it's a coincidence he's made it out of all those?
Hold on really quickly. Oh, so that takes me somewhere else entirely.
Battle's okay. Alive.
Okay. Can't believe Prompto actually did not. What's this? You just gonna rush in like that? Text targets from behind.
Got any better ideas?
I will try my best, but that hasn't always worked out.
Should be easy for you.
Too easy even.
Attack target from behind.
I stand. I'm closed. Get lost.
Wonder what drew you to the world.
Little curiosity.
One way to find out.
All right, so that's one. Oh, I should equip my gun, so because there's no teleport points to do the trick with to teleport there and airstrike when ready. So until then, I shall shoot it with my gun, like a plebe. Yep, making short work of these things. Awesome. All right, sweet.
None the worse for wear.
Bring on the next one.
Ooh, Gladio picked up an ether. That's an... How helpful are ethers in this game? What do they do, actually? Because magic is not as big as a deal. I mean, ether, what does this do? Oh, yeah, so I would only be using that on Noctis. Oh, sweet. So now I have some teleport points. That's not what I wanted to do.
Enough talk. Time for some action.
You're a nice guy.
I think I need to increase my ability to air step because I fall to the ground too quickly in order to make the trick work. Oh, I have to remember I can dodge in the air too, so. Alright, this is being annoying. Yeah, just shoot them out the sky. There's the next one. Not nearly as interesting, but effective. Oh, but he's dodging them very well, though. Okay, so. Alright.
You're out!
Sweet. Yeah, I think I need to add. Let me see. Let me go check the ascension really quickly for that. I need to be able to air step more. 52. Okay, so, or maybe I just gotta get. Yeah, I just gotta get better with it. The next one takes 52.
A tomb fit for royalty.
Ooh, let me change there. For the sake of cutscenes, so that no one a big one's coming up, let me change their gear so they're cutscene ready.
Let's go in and find the marshal.
Royal tomb. Open.
Marshal.
At last, Your Highness.
Yeah, that looks good.
Wanna tell me what I'm here for?
The power of kings passed from the old to the new through the bonding of souls. One such soul lies before you. To claim your forebear's power is your birthright and duty as king.
My duty as king of what?
Now is not the time to question your calling. A king is sworn to protect his people.
And yet he chose to protect only one prince. Was that his calling? Forsake the masses to spare his own son?
How long will you remain the protected? The king entrusted the role of protector to you.
Entrusted it to me? Then why didn't he tell me that? Why did he stand there smiling as I left? Why? Why did he lie to me?
Again, Ray Chase. Give excellent performance. Great.
That day, he didn't want you to remember him as the king. In what time you had left? He wanted to be your father. He always had faith in you, that when the time came, you would ascend for the sake of your people.
Guess he left me no choice.
Ah, the music in the background. It's like, it's really nice. royal arm has been added.
The power of kings goes with you, your majesty.
Sweet. Got a brand new sword to use. The royal arms are mystical weapons embodying the power of rulers of old. Usable only by Noctis, these weapons are incredibly powerful but cost HP to wield. Try not to get carried away. And curatives such as potions on hand to bring Noctis out of danger. Note that the royal arms do not include link strikes, induced link strikes. Oh, okay. Good to know. All right. Can't do team Sword of the Wise. So I'm going to equip that like right. Oh, and look, it added Armiger. It's cool. They all like their numbers for something. I wonder what their meanings are. If they have meanings. Oh yes, gear. That's what I was doing. Got a little sidetracked there. Sword of the Wise. Alright, let's go talk to Kor.
That's not the only power your forebears left you. Your journey's just begun. Another tomb lies close by. I suggest you head there next. There are tombs scattered across the land. All are on dangerous ground. I'll go with you, for the time being. Not only to help, but to get a measure of your strength.
Sweet.
So, all right. Just how many of these powers are out there?
There are 13.
Damn, look at his health. 3,000.
Shrined at a royal tomb.
He outclasses us by a bit.
I've enlisted the help of the hunters. They comb the land in search of the lost tombs.
Where's the one nearby you mentioned?
Kikatrick Trench. We know there to be a crypt deep inside the tunnels.
All right. Let's head over. So, oh, hold on. I'll hold on to that thought.
Just don't get too carried away.
Let's tie a new sword. Oh, it teleports us there without having to press war strike. That's cool.
Watch this!
Done in a minute.
Time to spare.
It's good to have this now too, because
don't get used to it. I'll be gone before you know it.
I'll enjoy it while I can.
Given has his own technique, Lion's Roar. Wait, let me see if it gets added to the Ascension thing. Well, no, he wouldn't. They already, like, they're pre-done. That was a dumb thought. But, how far away is the next mission? Okay, a bit. It's a bit of a walk. Oh, shoot. Look at the magic things. Yeah, we got a battle. I sense a battle. Huge battle coming up. So, that cutscene got me thinking.
Long years ago, we waged a fierce battle here against the Empire. Mm-hmm. It all went to ruin. And after that, the Empire moved in like it owned the place.
Mm. Oh, so this was a deciding fight.
Let me give the orders this time.
All right, let's go.
Attack.
How do we get through all that?
Taking that on, or sneak up from behind. Choice is yours.
Oh no, that's not what I wanted to do. There we go. Whoa, what's hitting? There we go. That was okay, that didn't do that much damage, but I was getting hit like crazy there. Okay, good. We're in good shape so far. Let's check out the Lion's Roar, let's see what it does. Ooh, nice. It doesn't have a follow-up.
You'll get there with experience.
Yeah, he can mostly, like, one-hit these guys. Oh, Prompto. Let's give him a heal real quickly. So, yeah, that cutscene got me thinking because, like, about a conversation I had with a friend of mine about this game a very long time ago, about the nature of Noctis's character progression as the game goes on. He argued that maybe he's going to have to be one of those things where he's, like, really whiny and really, like, complaining about the nature of his journey until he grows to be like the king he needs to be. I argued that no, it's not necessarily that. I think it's more of a having this thing thrust upon him and having to accept that, growing to accept that instead of instead of whining and complaining kind of character. That's what he was worried about, and I think they wouldn't do that. And so far, I think it is him. It's more of an acceptance thing than a oh, woe is me thing. He's just sad that it had to turn out this way. Let's do this really quickly. Oh, can I use this gun? It's interactable. Oh, that's cool. Fire on my friends! Fire!
Yes, sir. I'm fine, sir.
Oh, how do I get out? Okay, cool. Alright, so I know I can interact with those now. Awesome. Appreciate that. Nice touch. Oh, I need to make another spell really quickly. Ran out. I used that lightning one up. Ooh, fuck that up. Meant to add an item. Oh well. Unicast is gonna be interesting to test out. But I'll use this Fire Thunder one first.
Armor. Dangerous?
This particular model poses a mild to moderate threat.
The short version?
Somewhat dangerous.
Marshall, you'd have to be pretty badass to take that down, right?
Think you're up to it? Let's see what you can do.
It looks like we have a dungeon coming up. That might take a bit of time.
No slacking off, Gladio.
Oh. Hello. Oh. Ooh, I meant to teleport. I fucked that up. Okay. Let's do this. Parry that. Nice, link strike. Awesome.
Gladio, do it!
Oh, I think he glitched out.
Nice work, Gladio.
Okay. I should figure out what this thing is vulnerable to. It's not vulnerable to a sword.
Watch out!
Let's do this.
Got it on its last legs.
Let's put it out of its misery.
There we go.
You all right, Highness?
Of course.
And you,
boom.
Marshall. No problem.
Cool, guys. Don't look at explosions. I was trying to do, because I know like parts of those Magitek armors are destructible, so I was trying to see if I can break the gun before I kill it, but we were doing a lot of damage, so whatever. I think, okay, so the next bit looks like a dungeon, and I feel like that's going to take a while, so I think I will end the episode here. See you in the next one, guys.